Hi everybody, hello Ted. This video is record of a special museum for a martial arts master in the States. He was trained in Japan and it was given by two names, his masters. In the school. So first this nickname Da Xiong in Chinese, I don't know how to pronounce in Japanese. It basically means big brother. And second name is actually, I should write the standard script. So this is the standard script, meaning leaves. Second character meaning above or on. And this character here is okay. To stay. So to stay on a leaf, it's really, I think it's very authentic name for a martial artist or like an ancient warrior. Remind me of the kind of light kung fu master in the movie Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, Hidden, I forgot the name, Wu Hu Changlong, the Lian's famous martial arts movie. So people kind of flying on bamboo, in the bamboo, fighting in the bamboo groove. So this is a kind of interesting. So I strongly suggested to keep that. Although we have explored other Chinese names, but I do like this one. So we decided to go with this. And on the official stamp or seal, we usually include this common character seal, the seal of Big Brother, Ye Shang Liu, or stay on top of the leaf. I mean, that's just the meaning, but for name, you don't have to really translate it. It's just maybe based on the sound and the meaning in Japanese. So I made some designs I can in the process, and thank Ted for commissioning and doing different designs. So we did explore the other options, like to make a round seal. Unfortunately, that one didn't work, but I can for the record, I will show that this is a nice design. But this stone is kind of rectangular, but for official seal, we can scrollize it. We can even make it into a round one if we wish. We can do that. But I decided not to take any future commission on round seal, because round seal is not suitable for official stamp. That's why 99% of official names stamp or inkan are square. You might see some inkan or name chalk. They're not even in Chinese sales script or kanji. They could be kanas or other common just like handwriting style or standard script. But they are usually carved by computer, laser, grammar on wood or plastic, not on stone. So the, in the seal stone tradition, we only do a seal script. We attempted to design a round seal on this stone. And this is the version number one, and with different characters, which is more workable. And you know, based on his name, we translated differently. We make a lot of adjustment in the process. You can see all the changes. This is another design I made. Actually, the first design I made. It's pretty cool, right? But it doesn't look like a Chinese, a standard Chinese seal. Too decorative, not you know, like a martial art. Instead, and we also explored that Chinese name in square format. But like I mentioned earlier, we like the original, the heritage from the teacher, so the given name, nickname, and the official name will be used by this great tradition of aiki, aiki, wushu, how do you say that? I forgot. Dadongyu. Okay, I can only pronounce Chinese, sorry. That's the style of the martial art. Let's go back to this. Design, that's what we're going to work. Here we go. I'm going to take one of these designs and put to make a stand on the stone. The stone has a sculpture of a line, so we usually make sure the line facing the user. Central on the left side, so you're never confused with the orientation. And I try to align carefully. I already removed the wax, it comes with the stone before the video. I'll use the acetone remover. Remover to transfer the laser jet computer printout onto the stone. And you have to use a thermal cartridge copier or printer for this purpose. There are some other kind of chemical works with the laser jet. I'm not laser jet, inkjet. I'm not laser jet. So okay, that's good. I'll make the according to my client's request, I'll make the margin border a little rounded with rounded corners. Thicker on the bottom. Because we have a lot of room on the bottom. We'll see how it works. Just cut one up. Just there is a mark too. Lunch myself. And then I'll fix this on the clamp. We usually do cut out the the shop, the corner, and the sharp edge of the stone. The stone is always nice if they come with a sculpture on the knob, because the more you use, you know, bad quality stones for sculpture. To the carving now. I try to cut as deep as possible because this is going to be an official certificate. You want it to be clean. Not the second to line or the column. design we need is up to pixel level, but here, you know, you see the real size. It's so tiny, so my cut cannot be so precise. I have to cut on the divine touch. Not really controllable. So we cannot really follow pixel to pixel. But I know that the idea of client is to make it more rounded on the corners. I'll try to implement that as far as I can. You know, you have to rely on your feeling, the sixth sense. Just as you fight, you kind of rely on your subconscious, spontaneous. If you do the right move, the result will be good. If you do it little by little, then it might not be so good. Now the last character of the given name by his teacher. Thank you.
put the last character is the seal. Characters with seal. Okay, now I'm going to fine tune some of the strokes. have to press too hard on this style because it will make the stroke thicker. If that's what you want, you can do that. It looks pretty close, and I do have the rounded border as requested. I'll make this part a little thinner, something on this side. That will be it. And some strokes to be done, especially on this big character. You know, I do act like the first cut if you try to overdo modification might destroy that kind of spontaneity. But they have this kind of, we call it military generals seal. When they receive a new commission, they got the seal carved in a hurry. That kind of, you know, direct approach is really nice sometimes. Gives a feeling of urgency that can, it's not perfect, but it has the natural chi or energy. Try to keep that. Unpolished look, I feel. There was an initial scratch on this character's brother, but it's on the thickest part of that design that really worked, actually, made that part with some, you know, like a crack. It balanced the whole thing, I think. Otherwise, that stroke between the upper and lower part would be too thick, I think. Too solid. So that scratch, I tried to reduce it. I could remove it with a very thin sandpaper like that. So, but I think I'll keep it. If you use thicker paste, that won't even show, I think. So I call it now finished. Let me make sure I got all the edges correct. The left is right, so it's some kind of tricky there. Do another test before we do the official stamp. I think that looks perfect to me. Okay, I'm going to make a thicker using fresh ink. Dry ink tend to have more texture, and a thicker fresh ink will have less grain. And if you blow some air moisture from your mouth, it will help to reduce the grain. See, I don't see any scratches on that one. Right? Let me show you a close up. That's the closest I can get. Okay. The actual seal is quite small, as you can see. So the design we made is on 200% a larger screen presentation. We worked really hard on every pixel. Don't need it sometimes. As long as the, you know, the general design is fine. It will, you know, turn out great. so I think Let me make an official stamp. Still, if you want to have thin lines, just press less and use harder padding also. That's a tip. And if you use less ink, it will also help. Sometimes, you know, my friend, artist friend, using fingertips to load the right amount of ink, just, you know, doing like a fingerprint. You tap your finger first and then load the ink. That way, not really good, you know, recommended for just to show you how the loading can affect the result. And that friend of mine would leave the loaded seal in the air for a minute or two, then stamp. So it let it dry a little bit. You know, it all helps. It also depends on what kind of seal paste you have. If you have very oily one or dry up one, or it's winter time, it tends to be harder, and in summertime, it's softer like this. You can put it in the refrigerator when you're not in use, so it will be firmer. I just use it every day, so I don't do that myself, but you can create a firmer result with a higher temperature, or you can soften it, warm it up. Okay. I'm going to mark the left with my signature as usual later. The host, my client wanted to match this official stamp of the school also, so we'll put it together. It's a little smaller, but similar style and shape. One yin and one yang. That works. I just press evenly. Lift carefully. Got it. Can clean the seal after using with a tissue. You don't have to do it after each print, but sometimes it helps to make perfect stamp from scratch every time. So let me do another custom copy card stock. This kind of paper surface is what needs to be used, I think. Okay, you can use this stirrer to make the surface smoother. So I just leave it there. Checking for missing spot. And if there's fiber, you can tap again. It will sometimes go back to the paste. You don't have to do this if you think the ink is already too soft. Okay, I think I made it upside down, so I'll flip it. Is the animal, oh, this way, sideways. But
it would be good to put it in a box like this. Horizontal orientation. Leave it. And let's do another one. Make sure the mouse, the face, facing you. That's the downside, the bottom side. Orientation. Press evenly, firmly, but not too hard. If you want a very fine line, and lift gently straight up. And you can see this, because the second load, I didn't clean up the stone, so it's thicker. And if you clean up, so it's like a double load. If you clean up the stone, I have better control on the amount of paste to put to load. Can I show you? It could be thicker or thinner, both nice. So with some practice, you can control it to your desired style. I just spotted something missing, but not necessary. Let me, yeah, blow a little air. That's just my old habit passed down from my teacher. Everybody do that, actually. That's a very dear copy, very dear imprint. On the design, I have more chipping border. I think maybe we should chip a little bit to echo the other shift strokes. So you want a perfect border. But you have to create some kind of a natural look. So this would be a little bit important. I planned. I think it's about right there. Chip a little bit there, and I'll do chip on this side. Cleanse that, and chip a little bit on top there. The chi enters. Yep, I like that chip. A little bit chipping makes the seal come to life, I think. Okay,
keep for my future collection book. Maybe. I already published one of the ebook with the early works. It's time to do the signature. This side. Hello, everybody. Thank you, everybody, for watching and following me on YouTube. If you're interested in making your own name seal yourself, you can go to our website to get the supplies of stone and carving tools. And also, you can order my service from there. Thank Ted for your continued support. I'm very happy to work with you. It's my pleasure. We have done 3 seals in a row with a very, very good experience. I really appreciate it. Thanks for all your patience and understanding. Hope you like this video, and we'll keep it up on YouTube as well. Thank you.